What's going on out there? This is the Ocelot King. And if you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast. Let me explain. It's free. There's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. Anchor will distribute your podcast for you so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. And you can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make a podcast in one place. So make sure you download the free Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started. What's going on out there? This is the Ocelot King. And if you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast. Let me explain. It's free. There's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. Anchor will distribute your podcast for you so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. And you can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make a podcast in one place. So make sure you download the free Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started.
Now I was barely 17 with a pocket full of hope, screaming dollar in a dream with my closet looking broke and my niggas looking clean, getting caught up with that dope. Have you ever served a fiend with a pocket full of soap? Nigga, I could tell you things that you probably shouldn't know. Have you ever heard the screams when the body hit the floor? Flashbacks to the pain, waking up cold sweat, 6 o'clock in the morning, gotta hit the bow flex, get my weight up on the block, keep watch for the cops, gotta love to serve a nigga 3 hops in a cop. Nowadays, crime pays like a part-time job, and the drought got me praying for a call time vibe. Summer rain come again, I'm the pain cause it's hard for a felon. In my mind I've been crying, know it's wrong, but I'm selling eyes, welling up with tears, thinking about my niggas dead in the dirt, immortalized on the shirt. Real niggas don't die, fall with the plot, 1745 form at the plot. Real niggas don't die, form on the plot. Real niggas don't lie, form in the plot. My niggas don't die, form on the plot. Real niggas don't die, form on the plot. Real niggas don't die. Real niggas don't die. Have you ever seen a fiend cook crack on the spoon? Have you ever seen a nigga that was black on the moon? Have you ever seen your brother go to prison as he cried? Have you ever seen a motherfucking ribbon in the sky? Nope. All I see is that cream, nigga, that green. I'm a black king, black jeans, I'm a black queen. And her ass fat, too fat for a flat screen. I'm the type of nigga make the whole fucking trap lean. Kingpin, nigga, put wings on a crack fiend. If they want a nigga, they gon' have to send a SWAT team. And I'm going out like Scarface in his last scene, a legend. What that mean? Real niggas don't die.
I'm attracted, I combat it, problematic. Every problem over addict, but that's just the way the cards fell. Heartfelt, but can you be cheated if God dealt? Fuck shit, only regret that I had is ever being regretful. I mean, they all try to kill me. None of them were successful. A few I knew for some years, some never met me and tried. But you can't kill nothing, it's ready to die. They say I'm in my own way, own way, and that's fine. I'm just living my own way, own way, like I can't die. They can move my heart, my soul, my take is tough. Feeling like Steven when he was up in that hospital. Nigga shot him 9 times, they got him thinking a lot.
heard that shit. Me and my girl got an agreement, dog. We don't do that.
I feel you.
Just a waste of money, dog. Inflated ass prices to make somebody think that they feel different than they do on a regular ass day. No, thank you.
I hear you on that, man.
So what's going on with you, man?
Not much, man. Just working.
Doing
the podcast.
Still
rapping.
Still rapping?
Yeah, I got a potential project I might be dropping, but I ain't gonna talk too much about it.
Gotcha.
Keep working on it. Any games you've been playing lately?
Oh, I was fucking around with the NBA joint. That's about it, really. And that free joint that they put on PlayStation, Tomb Raider. That game fire, dog. That shit's real tight. Oh, and that Destruction All Stars. I don't know how I feel about that one, man. Like, it's fun, but at the same time, it's kind of boring.
I think that's the PS5 exclusive, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, because on the PS4 they put out Control for free, and then
that shit. I ain't played that. I haven't played that yet. I'm gonna check it out though. I've downloaded it. I heard it was straight. I think it won Game of the Year, like when it came out.
Yeah, it was like nominated for it, I think. Something like that.
I think it won. I think IGN gave it their Game of the Year. Like certain, like it wasn't on like the Game Awards show. Like it ain't went there.
Okay. But
yeah, like third party people like IGN, GameSpot, like they got theirs. I think it won for IGN. So I'll check it out. It's the Ultimate Edition, so I don't know what the fuck that means. I'm assuming like all the DLC and shit.
Right, yeah. You gonna hop on that Hitman 3 that way? Because I heard that was pretty good.
You know what? Like, I fuck with like assassination type games, like stealth and shit, but Hitman ain't it for me, dog. Like, I've been waiting all these years for no skin and stuff, but they've been fucking with my head. And not giving my man enough screen time. I don't know what it is. Sam Fisher deserves justice, nigga.
Yeah, Sam Fisher is the GOAT when it comes to the stealth genre, for real.
Yeah, I'll never forget when they introduced, when they put the blade in the game, you can kill niggas through, like, plastics and shit, like curtains.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That was my shit. I was like, oh, man, these niggas really going ham. The last one that came out, I played the last one. It came out on Xbox. That one was like, when he was like, he wasn't really a civilian, but he wasn't part of the organization anymore, and they was out to kill his ass.
Oh, yeah, the Blacklist joint. That's the one I
played. Yeah, Blacklist. Yeah, that's the last one I played. That shit was fire, dog. Nigga got a kid and shit.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I think that one was the one where they changed the voice actor, like the main voice actor.
Yeah, I don't really know. I don't know, nigga sound the same to me.
any games you've been looking forward to?
They got this this one game, like the God of War joint, Ragnarok. That shit's coming out next year. Like, all the games I'm looking forward to coming out next year. I was looking forward to Cyberpunk, but we all know the story of that bullshit. That shit was a quick uninstall, dog. I downloaded it on a PC. Gave it about a week, 2 weeks. Nah, that shit's trash. It's boring, yo. Ain't got too many glitches. It's not like I thought it was going to be.
I actually like Cyberpunk so far.
You like Cyberpunk? Dog. Yeah, that shit's boring.
One glitch where the dude I was escorting, he kept like crouching and he wouldn't go nowhere. But once I restarted and reloaded it, it was fine. I ain't really had too many like big glitches so far.
Yeah, I prefer. So I downloaded Cyberpunk, completely distraught at the glitches and the bullshit. I wasn't expecting it to be like that. Like the way they were hyping it up, I'm thinking it's gonna be like a legit RPG. It's not. Yeah. It's a first person shooter with upgrades. That's all it is. Like the way they were talking about this game is supposed to be immersive, extremely interactive and hyper realistic and all this other shit. How big it was and how complex it is. Nah, nigga. That game is not it, dog. However, Ubisoft shocked me because this Assassin's Creed Valhalla, yeah, it's an Assassin's Creed game, but I fuck with it. I fuck with, like, the Vikings and all that shit.
Okay.
Yeah, that shit's dope.
Yeah, I'm still on the last one, Odyssey, because that one is, like, crazy huge, and it's got mad content on that one.
Exactly. That's exactly how Valhalla is, yo.
Yeah. If that'll help or hurt, depending on if they continue, like, the annual release of it.
Yeah. I think they need to take their time and not make one of those anymore. You know what I think? I think Ubisoft would actually be pretty good at making, like, a legit Splinter Cell game again.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, they need to bring that shit back. Oh, yeah, my home game sent me a link today, and it was the last Avatar. It's supposed to be an Avatar RPG coming out. Legend of Korra / Last Avatar, Last Airbender, Avatar Last Airbender. It's supposed to be making an RPG, so whatever the fuck that shit, get a trailer or whatever, I'll check it out. Low key hype for that, because honestly, that show. And like the Avatar Last Airbender and Legend of Korra, the writing and the animation in that show is the shit. Like, I don't think any show on Nickelodeon would ever fuck with that.
Yeah, them two was fire, even though I caught on late. I waited till they got to Netflix, and I became a fan of them.
Yeah, that's all right, man. At least you experienced it. You ain't fucking up like most people.
Right.
Yeah. Fired up.
You heard about G4 TV coming back?
You know, I saw that, and I was thinking to myself, like, they might want to have Adam Sessler or Morgan Webb on there. Like, it won't be like Attack of the Show, X Play. It won't be Cinematech, none of that shit. So I don't know if I'm really gonna fuck with it.
No, X Play and Attack of the Show, they coming back.
With the same people?
Yeah. They had a whole, like, reunion type thing.
Nigga, you telling me Adam Sessler and Morgan Webb is gonna be hosting X Play?
Yeah.
Summer, I'm hyped now.
Summer 2021 is when they coming back.
That's fire. I like Attack of the Show, too. But X Play was my shit, dog. When I was younger, I don't know if I told you this, but back in the day when niggas was low, you know, I was like, you know, Morgan Webb was fucking body, yo.
Yeah.
Her and Olivia Munn, nigga. Ooh.
Yeah. Olivia Munn, she got better, though.
Yeah, yo, she was an expert, huh? She did a model and shit, too.
Yeah.
And act.
She was in that Predator movie recently. That's what I'm saying.
I didn't see it. Like, which one? Like the, like, where they were like battling like on fucking Aztec pyramids or some shit. Like the Alien versus Predator movie, or which one?
No, it's like a newer one. I think dropped in like 2018 or something like that.
Yeah, I ain't seen that one. The last one I saw was Alien versus Predator. That was a grip ago. Man, that was a while ago, though. That was like 2008.
Yeah.
2007. Shit, it might have been 2005, nigga. I don't know. It was a while ago.
Yeah, it was a while ago. I like the second one of that one. I didn't really watch too much of the first one.
That's all right.
The second one, they ended up, they nuked the whole town. That was crazy.
Actually, you know what? I think I've seen that one. They took out a whole population, nigga. Shit was crazy.
Yeah.
You gonna watch the Super Bowl?
You say it again?
I said, you gonna watch the Super Bowl?
I'm debating on it.
Same. I'm sitting here. I was, oh my God, dog. Lamar Jackson, dog. Schultz, I guess the fucking Buffalo Bills, nigga. That shit ruined my day, dog. I ain't even gonna go to work the next day.
Oh, man. I mean, they said the wind was pretty strong. You know what I'm saying?
Both teams. Yeah, I get it, though. But Justin Tucker, dog. He was choking. Lamar Jackson, he threw a fucking pick in the end zone, nigga. That's when he threw that pick in the end zone, I was like, all right, this game is a wash, nigga. I ain't watching this shit.
Yeah.
And then I was looking at the play-by-play. Cause I didn't watch the game physically, but I like to watch like the play-by-play on like ESPN. And I saw that school anymore. It's about to get wrapped up. Bum ass nigga was gonna be this after we destroyed the Titan.
Right.
Well, we lose to those. Honestly, I think we had a good game against the Chiefs, you know. They haven't beat the Chiefs. We can't beat the Chiefs since we had Lamar Jackson as the quarterback.
Yeah, we lose to
the Chiefs. They are, nigga. They have fucking kryptonite, and I want to beat them.
Yeah, we got to get them at least once. They beat us 3 times in a row.
Yeah, well, he's breaking up.
What'd you say?
I said he's breaking up.
Because they beat us 3 times in a row, so we definitely got to get them back at least one of these times.
Yeah, man, it's bullshit. I don't like it. We need to come through on something. I think we're going to have some personnel shifting around. Yo, we need to beef up our defense on some real shit. It was already fucking retarded that we got rid of C.J. Mosley. Yo, if we would have had C.J. Mosley and Patrick Queen, oh my goodness. Like, I fuck with Patrick Queen. He an animal. Like, solid linebacker, dog. But I feel like we give up too much. Every day we lose like key ass players. And then we got rid of Earl Thomas because we wanted to be fighting niggas on the team. So that shit was I don't know. The outcome could have been different if we had somebody strong in our safety division. Defensive linemen. We got Calais Campbell, but that nigga need help.
We need the opposite. I think it's our offensive line. Because whenever somebody go out on the offensive line, we always got trouble.
Yeah, we had injuries and shit. And we lost the legendary Marshall Yonder. So.
Yeah, and then Ronnie Stanley, he like our best lineman. And he was out for the year.
Yep. And I saw Lamar Jackson, I feel like he ran. Like, he got touchdowns and shit. But I feel like he just didn't run enough. Especially postseason, like post regular season, dog. Playoffs, he should have been getting at least 100 rushing yards a game.
Yeah.
I think it's too deadly, man. I don't run outside the pocket. And the thing that kills us is that people getting used to these play options, and they going straight for this nigga every time.
Right.
So we need to develop some pass plays that integrate this nigga running. You know, do a fake bootleg and let him run, dog, instead of passing. But, you know, I ain't a coach. I'm just a nigga that likes football.
Yeah, I definitely seen a lot of people saying we need to, you know, swing them outside more and have them throwing outside the pocket instead of opposed to inside the pocket.
Yeah, because he's not an inside the pocket quarterback.
Yeah.
That nigga could be 10 yards from the line and still bomb that bitch downfield. Or take off and gain like 30, 40 yards.
Right.
Past the line of scrimmage, though. So, I don't know. I like our running backs, though. That nigga, Graham, he's straight, but the new dude we got back there, not him, but what's his name? Yeah, yo, J.K. Dobbins. That nigga's going to be a problem. Yo, he's going to be a problem, dog.
He is a problem already.
Yeah, he's going to be on some real, real Hall of Fame shit. He keep playing the way he is. I like to see where he go in his career. Hopefully he don't fuck up like Ray Rice.
Right.
Or hurt himself like Jamal Lewis.
Yeah, him and Gus Edwards is a great 1-2 punch.
Yeah, Gus the Bus.
Yeah.
I think that we call that nigga that too. We need to get him a better name. I don't want no association or affiliation to any Steelers forever, dog.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, on some real shit. Like Jerome Bettis was a problem. I don't want our guys to have any affiliation with any Steelers player.
Yeah, I agree with you on that one.
Call them something else. Gus the Train, nigga. They don't got a home. They don't got a rhyme, dog. Let's see what the 2021 season is like. Let me kick off. I got the Lakers, though. I got the Lakers winning another championship.
You said you got the Lakers?
Yeah, boy.
Even with the Nets in the East, with Kyrie and James Harden.
Fuck all I know is, nigga. It don't matter. Yo, the Clippers had the dream team, dog. They ain't do shit with it.
True.
Lakers, they got that chemistry, man. And they got two high-caliber Hall of Fame players. First ballot Hall of Fame, LeBron James, and that other nigga, I forgot his name.
You talking about Anthony Davis, right?
Yeah, AB, yeah, the tall nigga. Yeah, dog.
The brow, unibrow.
Yeah, the unibrow. Like, we gotta get rid of Alex Caruso. Gotta get rid of that nigga.
Hell no.
Nah, we gotta get rid of him, dog. We need somebody more strong on the point game tip, dog.
Caruso a solid backup.
We need like a Fred Van Fleet on the point guard tip. Calorie. We get like a Fred Van Fleet, somebody who can go out there and bang shit. We need solid.
You play my player on 2K21?
Yeah, I play that shit.
Who you got drafted to?
I think I played for the... Nah, hold on. Let me think. I ain't playing in a minute because I do the my GM shit, my NBA, and I use the Bulls. But the my career, I think I got drafted to... I want to say the Jazz... Or the Pelicans. One of the two.
Were you a point guard?
Nah, am I a point guard? I don't even know, yo. I don't play it like that because that shit's kind of slow. And I don't like the fact that my overall is high as shit. My stats is good, but I play like a fucking bum. Like, I don't know what it is about it. Like, you need badges, but you gotta play like a shit ton of games to get your badges. And I don't like that. Okay. I guess too much. Too much time, dog. I'd rather just play a whole season with the Bulls, do some trades, manage a squad, pick up some free agents, do the draft. Like, I like shit like that. I'm a franchise guy.
Got you.
My career shit is like a distraction. Like, if I want to, like, chill out, don't really give a fuck, I'll do that. I've been on the
my NBA
joint. Heavy.
So the New Music Friday, you check out any of the songs I sent you?
So I didn't check out any of the songs. Cause I haven't got one to it. Yeah. Cause I've been busy. Another shit. Fucking car racking up, work and shit. However, I do on Spotify liking songs now. So it's a handful of songs that I heard that were new to me that I liked. I'm gonna share a couple of them with you. Maybe it's on the new Friday joint. Obviously, D Smoke is not won't be on there.
You said he
won't. Yo, that's so. Yeah, because I mean, he ain't really new. Like I was listening to the Gaspar Younger today. Yo, that shit is fire, dog.
Is that like an African?
Nah, nigga, it's D Smoke and Snoop Dogg. The name of the song is Gaspar Younger.
Oh, gotcha, gotcha.
Yeah, that shit's fire. I heard the new joint by Wale that moved different, moving different. That shit's fire. And I checked out Coda the Friend.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, his shit's fire, too. Like Long Beach.
You heard that new Freddie Gibbs and Schoolboy Q record?
Nope. So I
haven't. Oh, man, you gotta check that out.
I did. You know what? I heard a song off of there, but I haven't listened to the album. And I don't remember what song it was, but it was on my daily joint. Like, the daily playlist, it was on there. Like, I liked it, but it was all right. Like, I wasn't really paying attention.
Okay. What about G-Eazy and Chris Brown? They got this new record with Mark Morrison.
I don't know who that is, yo.
Mark Morrison?
Nah.
Return of the Mac.
What?
Return of the Mac?
Macklemore, nigga?
Nah, Return of the Mac.
Nah. Brandy Mac? He coming back from the dead, nigga? Like, I don't know who that is, yo.
Yo, Return of the Mac.
I don't know, dog.
Return of the Mac.
I don't know that one. I do know I like this one song by M. Huncho and Nafe Smalls called Wrong Time. That shit's fire.
Okay. I don't know who that is.
Yeah, some new nigga. And then We Ball by Ace Hood. Shit's fire. I just listen to the new music Friday
because
that shit changed every Friday.
Yeah.
So, let's do it.
Check
it out.
Last album was really good.
I,
like, it surprised me.
Oh, the 8 joint?
Yeah, it's called Mr. Hood. That whole album was solid.
That shit ain't surprising, dog. You hear his Undisputed joint?
Nah, that's like the first whole project I heard from him. Even
though you haven't heard Undisputed, dog?
Nah, like you used to tell me about like a lot of his projects, and like I'd be like, all right, yeah, but I never actually checked them out, so that's my bad.
But,
yeah, he killed that.
Undisputed is his best album on some real shit, and you need to go listen to it. That shit is like real, dog. Like, he put his heart and soul into that motherfucker. But this weed, like his new shit, is fire. But that Undisputed was like his comeback, like a real hard comeback into the game. This nigga Ace Hood ain't fucking around, yo. I feel like the industry treat Ace Hood like they treat Joe Budden. Like Joe Budden got fired, dog. He got heat. People be clowning his ass though, because he be saying some off the wall shit, and he stay under the radar.
Yeah.
Ace Hood under the radar, dog. Nobody knows about Ace Hood like that. Especially these young niggas. So, Ace Hood got that fire. He got that heat. Niggas a true artist.
You see his Drink Champs interview?
Who?
His Drink Champs interview? Drink Champs is Nori's podcast.
Nah, I don't be watching interviews and shit, dog.
Do you fuck with Nori?
Nori? Like Noriega?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. He got some fire. I ain't hear that name in a while, though.
Yeah, he been podcasting, but in the interview, they talked about how everybody was comparing Meek Mill's style to Ace Hood's style. And,
Completely different, nigga.
How they said Ace Hood influenced Meek Mill's style. And Ace Hood was like, yeah, I think I did.
I don't know about that. I mean, I can see it, but I don't know. I don't really look at other niggas and be like, oh yeah, he remind me of such and such. Like, I just take it for what it is, like face value. And when Meek Mill first came out, I was a filler that nigga. Like, I ain't really fuck with Meek Mill like that. Because his style of rapping, it just didn't gel with me initially. Yeah. Until I listened to his, what is it, that Dreams and Nightmare album?
Oh, right. Yeah, his first
album. Yeah, that shit was fire, dog. Like, I had to sit down and listen to it. And he had some heat on there. And I was like, all right, cool. Meek Mill doing Philly justice for this shit.
Yeah, he be hit or miss with me, but I mess with him overall.
He got this is one song he was on, yo. That shit is fucking, it's called That's My Nigga. Dog, oh, that shit is fucking heat. It's from the Bright, that movie Bright of Netflix. It's from that soundtrack.
Yeah.
And got like Snoop Dogg and shit on there. Nigga, that shit is fire. If you never heard That's My Nigga from the Bright soundtrack, you slipping, dog.
Yeah, I think I heard it while watching the movie, but I ain't never go back to it.
You gotta hear the whole shit, dog. That little snippet don't do it justice. Like, it gets you hyped, but you gotta hear the whole fucking track.
Got you. Oh, so speaking of D-Smoke, though, he did drop the deluxe of his album, Bad Habits, on Friday. He got this record with Snow the Product called Debo.
Yeah, I think I heard that.
Yeah. They went
home. Yeah. Yep. E-Smoke, the nigga that won a rap competition on Netflix, dog. He's on his way. Tell me, he keep doing what he's doing, and he stay fresh with his shit, he won't have no problems.
You know who his brother is, though, right?
Nope.
Oh, man. So his brother is Sir from TDE.
Who?
Sir from TDE, the R&B singer. I know you heard.
TDE?
Yeah, Top Dog Entertainment.
Yeah, I know what it is, but I don't know who that nigga is.
Yo, Sir got like.
What is it? Say his name again.
Sir, S-I-R, but I think he's like.
Oh, yeah, nigga, I don't think he was saying Sir. Like, you put some shit on the pancake, nigga. I knew that's how I are, nigga. Sir, yeah, okay, gotcha.
So that's his brother.
Right. I don't know this nigga. Hell no, this just seem a little skeptical, man. I feel like nobody else from that TV show had a chance. I feel like it was a lot for that nigga from the jump.
No, the talent been there, but.
I mean, the talent there, dog. He just needed an outlet. He needed to put himself on the map. And that show was up. Because he was like a teacher or something. Wasn't he? He was like a high school teacher or something.
Yep.
He taught music. Yeah, he taught music. And he speaks Spanish and shit. So he was already, niggas already talented, dog. So, yeah. I fuck with D-Smoke, though. That Bully song is my shit.
Yeah. I had to throw that on the playlist.
Yeah. Bully's the best. You gotta listen to that Gasper Younger, dog. That shit, I'm telling you, you listen to Gasper Younger, that should be on the list.
I did go through the whole album at one point.
Yeah. Probably the hardest song that you don't remember.
Yeah, probably. No, Bleach coming back out with the anime, right?
Who?
Bleach coming back out with an anime.
They making more? You know what? I ain't shocked because the way Bleach ended, I thought it was going to be some follow-up shit, dog. I thought, like, this nigga, like, Ichigo got his powers back, and then he lost them. Like, I don't know. That was a stupid ass way to end the show, and I didn't like it. Like the Arankas and shit, like they were tough, and you got, you know, Aizen bitch ass in there, which they ain't really kill that nigga, dog. I don't know. That shit was a little fake to me. I didn't like the way it ended. So I always thought, man, they probably gonna come up with some more shit. But that was years ago, so I gave up hope.
Yeah, I ain't make it to the end yet, but...
Nigga, what? Doug, I just pulled some shit for you, Doug.
Yeah, you ain't say that much.
Man, come on, Doug. You ain't finished Bleach?
No.
I can understand if you sit here and be like, oh, I ain't really caught up on One Piece. And it's thousands of series. But Bleach, nigga, come on, Doug.
Yeah, that and Shippuden, I still gotta finish.
Yeah, you gotta get on that one, yo. They got the whole shit on Crunchyroll.
Okay. I actually downloaded all the episodes and I got them in my Apple Cloud.
Oh, all right, Pirate Bay ass nigga.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They said Black Clover gonna stop the anime after this season.
Yeah, I know. So they can catch up with the manga, I think. Yeah, that shit irritates me, but at the same time, I respect two-season anime. Yeah. And I tell you why. Because they keep you enthralled the whole time. Like, they don't really buff it up with, like, fillers and shit. Like, One Piece, that's, like, 600 episodes dedicated to fill.
Them fillers be fire, though. Some of them.
You said what?
Some of them fillers be fire, though.
Yeah, but I don't really want to watch that shit. Like, yeah, they can be fire. Like, Naruto had some fire-ass ones. Naruto Shippuden had some fire-ass ones. But really, I just want to see this nigga continue to track down Sasuke and fuck up the, what it called? What's some niggas got? Yeah, Katsuki. Yeah, fuck them up. That was the whole point. And then they started going into, like, gods and shit, and the world tree, Yggdrasil, and all this other extra shit. Nah, it was getting fire, dog.
Yeah.
And then you go into a filler about some shit back at the village. Like the last episode, these niggas was, yo, Menchi just got killed, dog. And y'all gonna throw a filler in? Alright. Cool. I don't fuck with my emotions like that. They killed my boy Menchi, and then they gonna throw in the filler.
So I didn't get to that part yet.
You said what?
I didn't get to that part yet. Where they killed Neji? I know about it already. Because y'all talked about it before. But,
I'm telling you, when you see it, you're going to be hurt, dog.
Is it an unnecessary kill? Because I feel like that shouldn't
happen. Nah, dog. Nah, it was touching, dog.
Okay.
Like, it had to be done. Right. Type shit. Like, my nigga Neji went out like a G.
Okay.
Like, you remember when they killed Jiraiya? Like, yeah. Pain and all the niggas killed his ass?
Yeah.
Hey, yo, Neji kind of did the same thing, but he ain't get murked like Jiraiya did.
Okay.
And obviously, you've already seen Asuma get killed, right?
Yeah, that was fucked up.
Yeah, that was fucked up, dog. That was fucked up. Like, that's what I'm saying, you know, like, Shippuden had a fire-ass episode, yo, really well written, and they throwing a fucking filler, though. Like, don't break up the drama like that. Keep that shit going. It's a weekly show.
Yeah. You catch up with Boruto?
Yeah, I'm caught up on it. It's getting good. I watched the last episode, my man, what is his name? Miguno? The dude with the fucking goggles? He sacrificed himself.
Hold up.
Come on, man. You want to talk about this shit, but you ain't even caught up, nigga. Come on, dog.
I know, man. I'll catch up.
That's a big-ass twist in that shit, though, because, like, one of the OGs from the war is acting like a real fuck nigga right now, and I don't like it.
You said an OG from the war?
Yeah, dog. You'll see. When you catch up, you'll see. But Boruto isn't like Naruto, you know, like, it's peacetime, technically. But, like, they try to do some war-type shit. But Shippuden was raw, nigga. Like, Naruto was a perfect build-up to Shippuden. Because, like, they were in a time of war. Like, it wasn't never any peace. All the villagers was ready to come for niggas. The village hidden in the mist, all assassins, nigga. The only way you living in that bitch is if you make it out the hunt. So, like, it ain't like that no more. Everybody all happy and shit.
Oh, yeah.
So, it ain't no conflict. Ain't gonna be no Zabuza and shit like that. So, everybody happy. For now.
Right.
Like, they threw in some shit. That's like, oh, man, that's fucked up. But it's nothing like shit either. Not even a little bit. Shippuden had hitters, dog. They had real niggas in that bitch. Boruto, the hardest part of the whole show is when Naruto, an OG, and Sasuke, an OG, fought that god nigga. When Naruto got captured. And they were fucking his ass up, dog. They went to go rescue my nigga, dog. Best fight scene in the whole show.
So overall, do you fuck with Boruto as a continuation, though? Like, do you think it does?
They want to continue it because this is a new iteration of, like, Naruto with Boruto. So they're going to probably have, like, a Boruto Shippuden or some add-on like that. Maybe the next part when they get from Boruto to Boruto Shippuden or whatever the fuck they want to call it, maybe that's when shit get real. Right now, that's a slow build-up.
Okay. Because, yeah, they did a time skip too, right? Because I seen, like, different
phones
Boruto growing up or as a teenager.
That's what tells you that they're going to have the next iteration. Because he's still a kid. That nigga ain't nowhere near that adult, like you saw, like the first episode, what is half eye and shit. Like, he ain't there yet. And I think, you know, they leading up to get to that point. They just not there yet. And I honestly think they gonna kill off Sasuke. That nigga's gonna go. Sabra is gonna turn into a fucking beast. Probably become the next Okage. Naruto will probably get killed off. Because, I mean, he gotta die at some point.
Yeah, I can see that.
All the OGs are gonna get knocked off. I think that's gonna happen. The only one I think that's not gonna die is, what's his name? Shikamaru.
Oh, the strategist? Yeah, he a beast.
You said what?
The strategist dude?
The strategist, nigga. Yeah, the strategist. His dad was a fucking beast. Shiki died?
Yeah.
And he died in the war with homeboy who acting like a bitch in Boruto, dog. Like, you gotta watch it. This shit pissed me off. And then,
You said Shikadai died?
Yeah, he got killed in the war, dog. And Shippuden. Oh, you ain't get there yet. Oh, come on, man. Come on, man. You gotta fucking get on it, dog. This shit's crazy. Like, the resurrection of Madara, Uchiha, nigga, that shit, it was like world war against this one soul nigga, dog. And he was winning. Madara was winning, dog. He won, nigga. So, I'm telling you, you gotta get on it, dog. This nigga brought meteors out of fucking space, nigga.
I seen that. Yeah, that was crazy.
I'm telling you, you gotta get on it, dog. Like, you played, like, the Ninja Storm games, right?
Here and there, yeah.
Yeah, so Ninja Storm 4 is pretty much the conclusion of Shippuden.
Okay.
Like, that's the end of it. If you played Ninja Storm 4, that is the end of Shippuden. that is a conclusion of the show. Because, you know, the Japanese and the manga and shit is way ahead of the animation.
Right.
So, yeah, dog.
Yeah, I'm not that far off. I think I left off where Itachi was a puppet. That puppet phase or whatever in the war is where I'm at. Like, a little bit after that.
Gotcha. Yeah, you got a ways to go, nigga.
Oh, damn. Okay.
Yeah, it'll be worth it, dog. If you ain't even get to, like, Shippuden dying and Neji dying, you got a ways to go, nigga.
You,
I think my favorite part of Boruto is actually seeing what's that dude, the Ninja Hound. The Ninja Hound user, his dog is old as shit, dog. Like, that nigga ain't even active no more. He's so fucking old, it's adorable.
What's his name?
It's not Kiba. No, it is Kiba. So Kiba, dog, I forgot the name of the dog. Akamaru? Yeah. Akamaru. Yeah, that nigga is old as shit. And Kiba got a new dog, but he still kept Akamaru, which is some OG shit. And Akamaru, old dog, he teaching the new dog, Kiba got, how to be a ninja dog.
Oh, that's dope. Yeah.
I'm telling you, you gotta get on it. Like, it has, like, little moments in there that make you say, ah, man, that's dope. Like, people old and shit, like Killer B old. Like, all the niggas is old.
I was hoping the black people ain't die in the war.
Nah, so that village hitting in the mountains of stone or whatever.
Yeah.
They still G's, yo. They still OGs. One of that dudes, the young dude who was shot from Shippuden, he's like the right hand man of like Killer B. Okay. That shot, he's a fucking beast. Yeah, that nigga nice, dog.
I seen something that said there's a Demon Slayer video game coming out, and
yeah,
it plays like the Ninja Storm series.
Yeah, it's gonna be an arena fighter.
Yeah, you want yeah. That?
I got you, by principle, yo. I watched Demon Slayer 3 times. I've watched season 1 3 times. Straight through. I love that show. That shit's real. And I already heard the reminiscences of, like, what's going to happen in season 2 based off of the manga. And I'm already irritated. So we'll see what happens.
Season 1 is like a cliffhanger ending, right?
Yeah, it's a continuation.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
I finished it, but I was like, all right, what's next?
That's when he was, he was following the fire dude to figure out how the fuck he was fire breathing when he fought that one dude in the woods, that spider nigga.
Right.
Yeah, but what they don't tell you is that his, like, Tanjiro's dad was a fucking Demon Slayer, dog.
Okay.
Yeah, but Tanjiro don't know that yet.
So he's gonna find that out in season 2, I guess.
I don't know when he's gonna find that out. I don't know. But apparently his dad was a fucking beast. He's the only one who fucked up the guy they looking for. That leaky demon dude. I forgot his name. Tanjiro, Nezuko, and Lightning dude. I forgot his name. He funny as shit, though. He a fucking beast. When he pass out, dog, and he using his one little move he can do to perfection, that thunderclap shit,
oh, yeah.
Fire. Yeah, that shit was dope.
You fuck with Fire Force season 2? I like that so far.
Yeah, Fire Force is legit. I watched all that shit. Fire Force is legit. Yeah, Fire Force is pretty good.
Yeah, I think I like season 2 so far better than the first one.
Yeah, it's only going to amp up. They about to start like a fucking internal war.
Okay.
So. So you got a, did you ever get on, Konosuba?
Who?
Konosuba.
Nah, what's that?
It's an anime. You gotta get on that shit, dog. It started off as a manga and they made it into an anime. It's funny as shit. It's pretty good.
Is it an action anime?
Yeah, you can say that. It's like an action comedy.
Okay.
Yeah, Konosuba and then Shield Hero is a good one. And the time I got turned into a slime, that one's pretty good.
You gonna have to text me how to spell that other one.
So I yeah, yeah. I'm, yo, I can send you a whole list. I stay on Crunchyroll, nigga. Stay on there. Like single list. I can put you down with some fire shit.
Oh, there's something. Oh yeah, the JoJo, JoJo's Bizarre. They got a spinoff coming on Netflix. I think next week. The spinoff series is going to be on Netflix, so I'm looking.
Like the reason I ain't finished JoJo, I stopped when it was like his grandson. Like it wasn't JoJo anymore; it was his grandson. It was his Jotaro or Joestar or some shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. After that, I was done because the shit just it just seemed repetitive. Like, I feel like they doing the same story over and over with the same style. And I wasn't
gonna
be fucking with it.
I ain't gonna lie. I don't even care about the story because it seemed like it'd be all over the place. I just like the art style.
The art style based off of the shit from the 90s, nigga, or 80s. When that shit come out? The 70s? It came out like the 70s or 80s. That shit been around for a while, dog. Actually, I think it came out like 1993.
You talking about the manga or something?
Huh?
You talking about the manga?
Yeah. So the manga came out in 1993, and then they released a show based off of the manga from 1993, but they used the same art style as they did in the manga, which is why it looked the way it looked.
Yeah, that art style was fire.
Yeah.
I like Fire Force art style a lot. Dr. Stone, which I ain't even finished that yet.
Yeah, Dr. Stone is heat, boy. That shit getting real, my nigga. Yo, you gotta get on Dr. Stone.
They in season 2 right now, right?
Yeah, man, the Stone Wars, yo. They in the Stone Wars, nigga. This shit getting real.
Baki spinoff. I know you mess with Baki.
Yeah, I seen Baki. I seen both seasons of it.
They got a spinoff coming.
I don't want a spinoff, though. I don't like spinoffs. Anything new. What is new shit?
Alright, the Resident Evil anime. That's gonna be
that funny. Shit whack.
You said whack.
Yeah, anything Resident Evil outside the game is whack, dog. Tell me one thing Resident Evil related that's good. The movies aren't good, yo.
The animated movies.
Nah, that shit ain't good, yo. It's not good. I don't care what nobody say. I'm just as whack. But I will say that Village game looked tough.
Villains look like a game of the year contender. I think that's dropping this year, right?
Yeah. They don't got a choice but to drop this year. Because next year is God of War Ragnarok coming out. So whatever game come out the same year as God of War Ragnarok is automatically gonna lose to my book, dog. Because God of War on the PlayStation 4 was my game of the year when that shit came out. That game is legit fucking good. So Ragnarok is gonna be even better.
Oh fuck! Did you
play God of War?
I ain't played that new one, but I bought the third one when I got the PS4, and I was playing.
Yeah, because Yeah, it was free. I downloaded that shit too, and I was like, it's hard because, like, you see Kratos then, right? He was still young. Mm-hmm. And then you see the trailer for God of War, and it is so old now. Yeah. Like, he's beefy as shit now. Like, in the God of War game, Kratos is fucking huge, dog. He's massive.
Yeah, the gameplay is a lot different, too. It got the, like, overhead type joint.
Yeah, it's like the third person over the shoulder shit. And then he got a kid, nigga was married, and that whole story, like, his kid, his wife, like, why he left Rome and shit, all that shit get clarified in God of War, dog. The PlayStation 4 version.
Okay.
But it intertwines with, like, Norse mythology, which is fucking dope. Like, his kid is a Loki, nigga.
So, do you have to play, like, the other games to play that one, like, to be caught up?
Nope. It's a brand new story, dog.
I'm going to cop that, then.
It's a brand new story with references to, like, past games, but it's not heavy on the past games. It's mainly pushing forward. Like, they got references like, this nigga took off the chain blades in God of War 3 when he ripped them off. Well, Zeus ripped them off or some shit like that. And he kept them, but he never put them back on. So he, like, wear wraps around his forearms and shit, but he still got them, like, underneath his house. That's why he told his son never to go down there, is because those blades is down there. But you keep playing the game, that nigga got to go back to the house because his son got took. And my man returned to that ruthless ass way. My man got them chain blades and started fucking shit up. I'm telling you, yo. God of War, PlayStation 4, masterpiece.
So, what's your favorite series from a video game, if you had to pick one?
It was Mass Effect. Then they fucked up. Mass Effect was my shit. And they completely botched it. But I would have to say my favorite game series that's consistently good across the board. That's a hard one, yo. I don't really know. I would have to say God of War. Because all of them games is good. Every single one of them. They got four God of War games. Five, actually, because they got the PSP one. That one was good. So they got five God of War games, and they all good. Every single one of them.
Wait,
the storytelling to the animations, all that shit. Sony and God of War, that's like the equivalent of Microsoft and Halo.
So time out. So Yarn Kelly took the black man off the voiceover work.
You said what?
Who was that dude?
Oh, you talking about the dude from, what's his name? He was from Stargate.
The dude from Living Single. He was the voiceover for Kratos, and they took him off. Y'all still,
no, they
still
didn't.
Supporting that?
Nah, they ain't take him off. Who told you that?
He did a whole interview. They took him off after, like, three games, I think.
You talking about Christopher Judge?
No, the dude from Living Single.
I don't know. Single. Is it a white dude?
It's a black guy.
So both voice actors for Kratos is black dudes?
I guess.
I don't know. I tell you, nah, the only voice actor I know that played Kratos is Christopher Judge, dog. And that's the dude from Stargate.
I don't know who that is.
That's a black dude. Yeah, that's the dude from Stargate.
Replace the black dude with a black dude. Okay. I ain't mad at that, then.
Yeah, Christopher Judge is a real one. I like him. Like, play the new God of War, dog. Telling.
Oh, Terrence C. Carson was the first Kratos.
I don't know that man. I didn't even need to look into it, because when I first played God of War, the first one on PlayStation 2, I already knew the voice actor was black, dog.
Okay.
No dude ain't bringing heat like that.
Yeah.
But that dude, yeah. I was like, oh yeah, this nigga black. Yeah, I already knew it was a black dude. I don't really give a fuck who it is. I know Christopher Judge is the only reason I know that nigga is because he was in Stargate. And when they was doing Game Awards, he was there to accept the award with that little boy who played his son.
Okay. Yeah, Stargate was fire. Anything else you want to touch on, highlight?
Shit, man.
Giving me a heads up that we got 5 minutes before the time limit. And I want to play at least one more song.
Gotcha. Nah, I ain't got shit else, though. I mean, if I can recommend you a song to play, yo, it'd be That's My Nigga, the outro.
Okay.
So, man, you go ahead and knock it out if you want. But other than that, yo, I ain't got shit else for you, dog.
What song you want me to end it off with?
I just told you, nigga.
Oh, what was it?
Oh, my fucking goodness. That's My Nigga, dog.
Asa, you said?
That's My Nigga.
Asa?
Nah. Meek Mill. Snoop Dogg.
Oh, okay. All right, I got you. All right, man.
All right, yo.
Thank you for co-hosting this episode with me. I appreciate you. I believe this is episode 9.
Oh, are you getting up there, nigga? You almost at DS, boy.
No, this is episode 10, so I'm in the double digits right now. So I appreciate you.
Got you. Well, Lord, y'all do your shit, man. Stay up. I'm about to get to the seafood bowl, nigga.
All right.
All right, yo.
Peace.